This is NDTV, and you're watching NDTV 24/7.
Welcome to We the People. Because of national outrage, finally there seems to be something happening vis-a-vis the tragic death of Ruchika Girhotra. It now seems clear that the central government has intervened and will be, in all probability, taking away the medals and pension benefits of DGP, or former DGP, we should say, SPS Rathore. But on the program today, we are debating, is that enough? Going beyond the role of SPS Rathore, who appears to have driven a young girl to her death after molesting her at the age of 14. Going beyond his role, what about the massive political and bureaucratic cover-up that this case smacks of? We ask today whether the case should be reopened, and when it's reopened, whether the role of all those who subjected a family and friends to criminal intimidation, who drove a young girl to her death, and who contributed at every stage to presenting themselves as obstacles in the path of justice, should be investigated as well. Before we go to our panel, I want to start with really three extraordinary people that I'm sitting with. Aradhana, Aradhana's father, and to my right, Ruchika's father, who have fought 19 years when none of us, including in the media, bothered to pick up this case and give it the primacy that we've given now. Rana, especially for you, you were there with Ruchika when she was groped and pawed by SPS Rathore. In fact, she managed to disentangle herself because you walked into that room. Are you finally feeling that things have started to move in the direction of justice? Or is this just really a tip of the iceberg?
Yeah, I think it's just the tip of the iceberg. But yes, I'm happy that it has at least started after 19 and a half years. Because nothing was done in these 19 and a half years, no action was taken. So at least it has started. So Rathore was found guilty, and now people know about it. And I mean, the support we are getting from people, and it's commendable.
What was the toughest thing for you and your family in these 19 years?
It's everything.
I remember you telling me that it's the day my freedom ended. That day in 1990.
That's right. I mean, the day I witnessed this incident, my freedom was gone. My childhood was totally changed. No fun in my life because I've never seen a smile on my best friend's face. So yes, things just changed for me totally. And my outlook towards life changed totally. The male psychology, I wanted to understand it now. I had many questions for my mom which she could not answer sometimes.
Why would a man do this?
Yes.
Starting with that basic question. And to me, the more basic question, how does he get away with it than walk out of court with that smile on his face? Girhotra sahab, aapne aur maine kai baatein ki hai is hafte. The one thing that you said really bothered you was that smile.
Yes, I don't want to see smile on his face. He's smiling. He's still smiling. This is a very sorry state of affairs.
When you saw that smile,
he was coming
out of court,
from the court, after conviction, and such a small conviction of 6 months jail after 19 months of trial. We were running after. There were 450 hearings. There was no need of 450 hearings. We were just four witnesses. Myself, Chashmuddin Gawa, she was with her, and Mr. Nand Prakash and her mother, Madhu, to whom she narrated the incidents immediately. We are the relevant four witnesses, and that's all. It should have taken not more than 19 days. It was a case of 19 days only. That's all.
But the FIR was never filed.
Yes, the FIR was never filed. Inquiry was conducted. A detailed inquiry, the then DGP, Mr. R.R. Singh, was conducted with all the witnesses. He submitted a detailed report. A detailed report. For and he recommended that FIR should be immediately lodged. He is prima facie a culprit.
And yet 19 years later you see this man walking out smiling.
Walking out smiling.
And you told me that that's the day you wept.
That's the day. Tomorrow.
And today also it enrages you in the same
For way. What you are laughing? For what you are laughing? 14 साल की बच्ची मर गई है तेरे कारण तू तू हंस रहा है इतना बेशर्म इतना दरिंदा तू एंड नोबडी हैज बदर्ड 10 साल तक एफआईआर लाजनी होती आफ्टर रिकमेंडेशन बाय द डीजीपी डीजीपी इज द कस्टोडियन ऑफ लॉ एंड ऑर्डर ऑफ द स्टेट एंड दैट हिज रिकमेंडेशंस आर ओके बाय द होम सेक्रेटरी
इन दिस केस द डीजीपी
होम सेक्रेटरी मिस्टर दुग्गल होम सेक्रेटरी इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर द लॉ एंड ऑर्डर ऑफ द स्टेट And he's recommending that FIR should be immediately lodged.
Well, we've got Mr. Duggal here with us on the show. And sir, I do understand your pain. And I know everybody here understands your pain. And I think the three people, you know, here are really extraordinary people in so many different ways. But Harish Salve, what does this say about us? What does this say about us as a country? Is it it's a moment of shame.
I'll tell you what it says about us as a country. The murderers laugh and the victims cry. That's what we are today. We have become so immune to corruption in our society. We have become so immune to abuse of power in our society that we elect those who inflict corruption on us. We elect those who abuse power over and over again. And so you are in a system where I don't agree with him the trial should have taken 19 days. According to me, it should have taken 3 days.
Not even 19 days.
3 days, 4 witnesses, half a day per witness, 2 days, 1 day for submissions. The case should have been over. The Enron trial, which was one of the most complex commercial trials, from investigation to conviction lasted 1 year or maybe 14 months. This trial should have taken 3 days. It took 19 years. No wonder the man is laughing. He's laughing all the way, literally, to the bank. I'm sure he has a lot in his bank. He's laughing all the way to the bank.
What is this smack of? A collusion between the political establishment and the police?
This smacks of a society which has lost its soul. We in India are a society which has lost its soul. We also wake up from Jessica to Ruchika. And in between we forget. I know of cases, at least 4 or 5, where indicted people under investigation, have been appointed to high police posts. I know for a fact that despite Supreme Court directions, not one state government has implemented police reform. I know for a fact that the central government refuses to change the Indian Police Act, although commission after commission has said the act is an anachronism. Ask Kiran here. She's a victim of bad governance where police is concerned. And I say so publicly, she won't say it. She's far too civil to say it.
Kiran?
But I'm saying so. What are we willing to do about this? What are we willing to make sure that this country doesn't produce more garotras?
But there is the question, the fundamental question, Kiran Bedi, is why did every successive government, and I'm going to put that to Manish Tiwari and also Ajay Chautala in just a bit, why did every successive political regime refuse to act against this man? I mean, if we look at it historically, it starts with the Chief Minister Hukum Singh not giving permission to file an FIR. It moves on to Bhajan Lal, who at that time, Manish, is with the Congress, who promotes Rathore to additional DGP. It moves on to Bansi Lal, who promotes him to DGP. It moves on to Chautala, whose government recommends him from a president's medal. What are we seeing here if not a ghastly nexus between the police and the politician?